Okay, welcome Yeong. Thank you so much for putting up your work. I'm very impressed with what we've put up today. Can you tell me a little bit about it?
Yeah. My first piece is called Islamic Expression, which I got inspired by Arabic women in Dubai and Iran, because I've lived most of my life in Middle East. So every time I see Arabic women, they are limited in showing their hair and skin. So most of them, I think they can only show their eyes. So they seem like by putting their eye makeup, it expresses themselves in their, like, as in personality and characteristics. So from this eye makeup, I got inspired by the desert in Dubai, the sunset. So that's why I used color like pink, purple, orange, red, yellow, which all suits with the sunset color. And yeah, and I also put collage in here. It's that it looks like it's inside. It looks that it's inside the scarf. I mostly use faces because every time I see every woman with different eye makeup, they seems like they have like different personalities inside their scarf. So that's why I put loads of random faces and people and animals inside their scarf, which explains that they have various characteristics and personalities.
Okay, fantastic. Tell me about number two.
And this is my second piece, which is called Multicultural. I've got inspired by Arabic men who wear turban, and I've drew the turban up here like hair, which I wanted to portray to the people by that these languages are coming from the head.
Okay.
Which is my head. So the languages up here is all like the languages that I learned during like for 18 years.
Okay.
So there are Chinese, Arabic, Korean, Farsi, and English. And I also just wanted to emphasize the language, so that's why I put shadows of different languages and their ways, like in their language.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay, fantastic. That's really impressive.
And this is my third piece, which is called Me, Myself, and I. I have used mixed medium. Used ink, watercolor, and acrylic, and I only painted this jacket blue because that jacket was like a representative of myself, because that jacket I wore it the whole summer. So
okay.
That's why I call it in blue. And I drew myself in different poses and face expression to show that I have different personalities and characteristics inside myself. And I've also used like an effect that they're inside the net, except for the big one. So this big one just represents the outside of myself. And
okay.
The others, which looks like they're inside the net, looks like they're inside of myself.
Okay, that's brilliant. I think you've captured that really well. It really does show an inner and outer personality. Well done.
Thank you. And the fourth piece is called Blooming. This is also a self-portrait, which I use mixed medium like acrylic, watercolor, and some wires. In this piece, I wanted myself to be expressed as a flower. So I use this kind of flower, but I also use this that I just wanted to be like meant, no, like vaguely. I wanted to just show
what would you, flower. What do you mean by blossoming?
Because in this state, I felt like when I was painting this, I felt like I wasn't. I'm inside in between that adult and the teenager, so I didn't. I didn't know where I was. So that's why, in flower wise, one flower is fully blossomed, and other one is layered with blossom and not blossom piece flower. So it kind of shows that I'm not fully an adult.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. Great.
On a wood, and I drew it on a wood because this piece really shows the comfortness inside me, and the expressions aren't really fake. They're really real, and I use black and white because. I think when you see a lot of color in a painting, like you really don't feel like calm down, and you feel more like excited. But this piece is a piece that I want people to feel comfortness, so that's why I use black and white.
Okay, yeah. And these these pictures look like you. They all look like self-portraits. Can you tell me a bit about that? Why you've chosen to look at yourself?
Because I used to be really bad at my worst drawing was drawing myself. Because I like to draw Western people because they have big eyes, big nose, and they have great faces, so they're easy to draw. So I was really bad at drawing Asian people. So from then I decided to draw myself. So I become more developed in other various. Drawing.
Yes. I understand. So you're challenging yourself,
yeah.
And that's fantastic. Okay, can you tell us about the next piece, please?
Okay, so this is a sixth piece, which is called Exploring. So I wanted to, because my dream is being married with an ideal man, but I didn't want to just focus on Korean traditional wedding. Because I'm living in a multicultural country in Dubai, so I do
The lily.
Yeah, lily.
That's
which
okay.
Is really commonly used in Western wedding. So it looks like so. This I want this piece to look like I'm opening a lily and I'm seeing myself a wedding with an ideal man.
Okay. And what do you mean an ideal man? I'm intrigued. How does that, what do you mean by that?
Ideal man is like a man who can earn money and just feed me. Because many Asian women, they depend on men or more than themselves. So that's why, yeah, I say ideal man.
Okay, thank you. And tell me about your next piece. Okay.
Okay.
And tell you, before you tell us a little bit about that, can you tell me about the technique that you've used there?
Yeah. First, I printed in oil-based ink, randomly, because this piece is called Please Get My Phone. When I was in like confusion and when I wasn't normal, so it meant normal mentally, so I just wiggled all that ink. To express my state,
okay,
my mental state, and then after it dried, I used charcoal to draw my face, in which I made it look like a chipmunk.
Okay.
Mac.
Okay, a piece of software.
Yeah, software. I took a picture from it and then drew it. So it looks because this effect kind of looks like I'm more desperate.
Okay.
For the people, person that I'm calling to get the phone.
Okay.
And
yeah. And what's in your hand there?
This is a phone. It's a phone.
Ah, okay.
Yeah. So it really took when I was calling to a person. So yeah, I was really desperate.
Okay.
And this is the next piece. It's called characteristic.
Characteristic.
This is also a self-portrait. I got inspired by the Stephen Bennett.
Okay.
Who uses very vivid color and various colors. And I have learned that he doesn't mix white paint and original paint color, because white paint tends to make the color more pastel-ish and not really strong. So I try to use a little bit of white in this piece, and I use really a lot of medias. Like I use oil pastels, color pencils, acrylic paints. Yeah.
Okay. So yeah, fantastic mixed media. Can you tell me about refining this idea?
Refining.
How did you come up with the idea, and how did you how do you come up with your ideas, and how do you throw some ideas away and prioritize other ideas? Can you tell me a bit about that? Not necessarily with this piece, but you can choose another piece, maybe that we've already talked about.
Not concentrated in focusing on making ideas, but I just get inspired by my everyday.
So in your everyday, some things are brought forward and some things are put by the wayside. How do you choose what goes forward? Like these poses in this piece are very specific. You're showing us different emotions. You know, you're kind of, you look thoughtful in one of the pieces, you look sad in one of the other poses. You look quite young in another pose. You know, can you tell me a little bit about that?
Well, I just pose, because they all look different, because they're all took, the pictures are all took in different period of times, and this was made in, this was created in like 2011, and they're, most of them are created in 2012, so that's why I look more younger and that piece I look more older.
Okay, fantastic. And can you tell me about your next piece?
My next piece is What's in My Bag, which is
Yeah, what is that? Where did that come from? What's in my bag?
Oh, I got inspired from the YouTube blog.
Okay.
Because I was interested in makeup. So the person who's shooting, she was like, she was explaining what she brings in her bag, like daily. So I got inspired that, like, my bag and what I bring daily represents myself. So because I've done a lot of self-portraits, I wanted to relate this inspiration.
Yeah, inspiration, that's
inspiration.
It.
Inspiration. So that's why I made a plaster casting of my bag.
Okay, and how did that process, can you tell me about that process?
I had to build clay. I had to build a bunch of clay, like thick clay, and then I have to build a wall around it, and then I had to push like stuff like pen and notebook and like keychains.
Okay.
And then you take them all out, and then you pour the plaster on it, and then you shake the walls to make sure that the air bubbles are out. And then after like a few hours later, I had to break all the walls and sides and then take the plastic casting out. And then
okay.
I had to paint it.
Okay, and what? Tell me about the paint scheme there.
I also got inspired by artist Stephen Bennett, who uses different colors and various colors. And I really liked it because it really shows different personalities and different emotions inside this piece. So I really liked
it. And the objects in this cast, where are they from?
They're all from my bag. Because this date I was really into painting and making portfolios for my uni. So that's why I had many art mediums and sketchbooks. And
okay.
Yeah.
That must have been a big bag.
Yeah.
Okay. So take us on to your next piece.
My next piece is this piece, which is called The Gaze. This is really my everyday. It goes into a catalog, which is called Journey. Because I was just walking down the street in my apartment, and then just a cat was staring at me for like a few minutes, and then it really appealed me to take photo of that cat.
Okay.
So, yeah, that's why I really was interested.
Okay, and what about the paint technique there?
I try to paint as real as possible. Realistic as possible, and I use acrylic for it because acrylic is really a good medium which dries quickly than oil painting.
Okay.
And it also has strong color compared to watercolor. So that's why I use.
Okay.
And then next piece is layer, which is called layer. I've got inspired from Greece.
Okay, yeah.
Greece economic crisis. And I have poured water in, like water, acrylic colored painted water on it. And then I started to draw on that. I've started to draw wallets, different kinds of wallets, which represents money. And I have poured water because people nowadays tend to use money like as water flows. So that's why I think that's why like Greece, they have met the economic crisis because they just use recklessly. Yeah.
Okay, that's good. Good.
And my next piece is called Dependent. This is also going into my journey, which I went to a pizza. I went to eat a pizza with my cousin, my aunt, and this is actually my aunt's leg. It's not a male leg, so I'm like, and then it because I drew this because my cousin is only like 2 or 3, and he really lived like he's depending on his mom, like he's depending a whole of his body into his mom. And his mom is accepting his dependence as with her leg.
Okay.
So that really inspired me in child growing and like developing and depending on mom and dad.
Yeah. Okay, yeah. That's a great piece. Fantastic detail as well. Well done.
I used charcoal, and also this piece I used charcoal, and I used acrylic, red acrylic. This piece is called Bus because in this summer I had to go to an art academy, so I had to take bus because I didn't have a car or I didn't have a subway next to me, so I had to take bus. So this was like my daily routine.
Okay.
So that's why I wanted to draw it, because that is one of my memory.
Yeah.
In summer.
Yeah, you've managed to turn a quite boring situation into something really beautiful.
Yeah.
Then that's a great piece.
I I also painted this in red because like most people tend to not hold this, what is it called? This
bar.
And they tend to fall down. So I just wanted people to know that there is a bar to hold it. Yeah.
Okay.
Kind of warning. And my next piece is called Oriental Nature. I've got inspired by Oriental paintings from my Asian culture because I grew up in a family which likes like ink painting, like ink Asian painting. So I tried to put that into a Western culture as well. So I put like lily.
Okay.
And some plant with a pot and Asianish waterfall and bamboo and flower.
Okay.
It's like a flower tree.
Flowering tree, that's fine.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. And I made it look like a slide, which is really commonly used in Asian families. And in Asian families, they're more big, but I just made it smaller because I wanted to focus on the drawings more.
Okay. Yes. And were there any particular artists that you looked at?
I looked into Hong In Suk.
Okay.
Like, he is an Oriental painter who uses like traditional ink and paper, and I also use traditional ink and paper in this piece to be more light to draw Oriental painting.
No, I understand. Okay. Great. And I'm moving on.
This is my next piece, which is called Peace. I've got inspired by the artist Shin Yeong An, who uses newspaper as a back base paper.
Yeah.
And she draws her self-portrait on it because she wants people to know that what kind of global issues that she's interested into. So I got inspired from that. So I put some newspapers in Greece market and Greece because I wanted to link this piece with that layered piece.
Okay.
About the money issue.
Okay.
That's going on now. And also I've put tulip, which is a representative of peace. Yeah, and I have casted my fingers and hands, feet, and which really links into my traditional issue, which is the war between Asia, Japan, China, and Korea, like in North Korea.
Okay.
So I wanted to express that within this piece.
Okay.
Like, because many people have died, and many people were used as medical, what is it like?
Experiments,
yeah,
or guinea pigs.
Human experiments. So they had cut their fingers off, like Japanese soldiers cut many Korean soldiers' fingers or like people's, they couldn't have. So
okay.
Yeah, I just wanted to put that in there.
Okay, no, that's brilliant. Tell me, but when you say the wall between Asia, tell me a little bit more about that. So you're Korean,
yeah,
and the wall that surrounds your neighboring countries. Can you say anything more about that?
We're always in fight because China has Chinese people, because it's a rumor, but this is like Chinese people tend to capture Koreans because Chinese people are nutritious, they're more poor, and Korean people are nutritious because they eat more healthy food. So that's why they capture Koreans alive, and then they cut it like they're cutting meat, and
okay,
they sell it because right, that's really good for their health or something.
Okay.
So that's really a problem, and also they have stolen Korea's national song, so that's why people really don't like each other.
Okay.
Yeah, and also Japan has is arguing that their island, like our island, is theirs, so that's why we're always in an issue.
Okay, so you're really sending a message of peace.
Yeah.
With this. Okay, that's a really interesting, powerful piece, Yeong. Thank you for sharing that with us. Okay, and can you move on?
Okay, I'll go to this one. This piece is Recycle. This is a series of my mental state. So this was held when I was really mentally sick and
okay,
mentally destroyed by bad memories and bad happenings. So
okay,
I made a trash bag inside myself.
Okay.
So when you see, there is expressions of people crying, shouting, and dead flowers, dead plants, and people who their poses are looking down, which feels more depressing.
Okay.
And then also I used darker paper to show more, and then as you go down, it goes lighter, the paper goes lighter, and this whole thing means that my or anyone's bad memories can be a base to develop themselves up and go to a next level. So that's why I made plants grow.
Okay.
From that, yeah, so it kind of shows development from
okay,
a bad situation.
Okay. And your last, this final panel, what's happening there? Sorry, the bottom, the picture at the bottom, yeah.
So the trash is inside this trash bag, comes out, spills out from here, half of them are gone, and they're coming out from here, and then from here, they're fully gone, and they're all moved into this side, which develops from depressing to outcome.
Okay.
So my outcomes are flowered and they'll grow.
Okay, and is this the state you find yourself in now?
Yeah, I feel much better.
Okay. And is there anything particular, I mean, I know it's aside from your art, that's made that happen?
Yeah, because mostly my family issues, when your mom says that, your mom nags about something that she doesn't like about me, but that's really from what she wants to, what she wants to help, I don't know,
okay,
get what I mean?
I think so, yeah.
Yeah. Because she wants to help me, she's nagging.
Okay.
But first time I get sad, really sad, and then
okay,
but as I grow up, I know that's gonna help my career and my future.
Okay. I understand that. Fantastic. All right. So tell me about your last. We've got a few minutes left. So very quickly, tell me about this lamp.
This is a recycled light made of plastic coffee plastic cups. So basically, I wanted to make a light with recycling materials. So I use plastic, which is great for light transparent.
Okay.
So I wanted to, and I made it in a fish because this golden fish
okay,
represents life. And that's why, and this light represents a new life, kind of.
Okay. Thank you. Can you just tell me quickly, sorry to cut you off, we're a bit short on time. Can you tell me a little bit, very, very, very quickly, about your life drawing here?
I've done my life drawing in the summer. It was my first time, and it's called Oriental Nude. which I put many, I use many like, different mediums and different poses of, okay. And different models.
Thank you very much, Yeong.